Hi everyone. I hope you all are safe and healthy out there. And first of all, I'd like to thank ONS for giving us the opportunity to present here today. I'm going to talk about the Liberty E-ROV system and how we are convinced that it can contribute to solving the challenge of optimizing fields through the use of new technology. So back in 2017, we did an offshore pilot demonstration, proof of concept for Equinor, showing that we could do this. And the offshore pilot was very successful. So that actually resulted in us being awarded the contract with Equinor for 3+1+1 years for supplying Liberty E-ROV services for their IMR vessel fleet in the North Sea. So the Liberty E-ROV concept is basically a world-class ROV that is operated out of a garage that we set down on the seabed. This garage has a huge battery pack supplying power to the system. It has a surface communication buoy tethered to the system so that we can communicate with the system through a broadband 4G connection to the onshore control center. And as you might see, there is something missing in this illustration, and that is the vessel. And that is not a mistake. It's the result of the concept is that we've taken the vessel out of the equation during the ROV operation itself. We only need the vessel for launch and recovery of the system. So we made an animation that will illustrate for you how this concept works, and I'll talk you through it. The system is about the size of a 20-foot container. It's launched from an IMR vessel using a subsea crane with a single point lift. The buoy, communication buoy, is stowed on top of the module, and as it passes through the splash zone, it remains on the surface, and there is a constant tension winch keeping tension on the mooring during deployment. All the time we have communication, so we are operational with the ROV during deployment, so we can assist in our own installation subsea. Here you see the ROV deploying the mud mats, and the system is landed on the seabed, and the crane hook is released, so the vessel can sail off and do other stuff. We have a 500 kilowatt hour battery, and we have a 1000 meter tether giving us a kilometer working range around the landing point of the garage. This illustration shows compares the conventional method on the left with the vessel ROV and the Liberty E-ROV system on the right hand side. And the graphs show the CO2 emission as time goes by. We see here that we bring the tooling we need for the operation, and the operation can continue for days or weeks, depending upon the intensity of the work performed. Now, here we see a torque tool being operated, so it's a fully world-class ROV. And as time goes by, the vessel continues to emit CO2 all the time, whilst the Liberty system is a zero emission system. And the longer the operation, the more the environmental benefits are. And here we see a chart illustrating the emission over the course of a year. We estimate about 22,000 tons of saved CO2. And that equates to about the same as 6,000 cars. So there's a huge saving here. So the environmental saving is obvious. We also have an HSE benefit in that we send less people offshore, reducing the amount of people we expose to the risks of being offshore. There's also the financial saving in reduced vessel time. There's a considerable reduction in the vessel time and a huge saving there as well. So there's plenty of good reasons for using the Liberty system. Here is a recording we did of a qualification testing done quayside in Stavanger, Mekjarvik, in 2019. And in this testing, which was the first testing of the system, we ran all the components through its paces, and we tested the ROV itself, the garage, and the launch and recovery system of it, the buoy you see there, and the battery system was really it's one of the largest battery systems ever built for subsea use. And here we see the control center. Everything is controlled from the onshore control center here in Stavanger. The testing was very successful. So the next month in June, we went offshore on the first mission. How was that for B? And after that, we have performed 28 missions over the course of the year and a half that has gone. And we see here a list of the different fields we've been working on and the type of operations that we've been doing. The work has ranged from inspection work, commissioning, and valve operations, etc., all types of IMR work. So the system has lived up to expectations and outperformed the expectations. And we are very happy with that. And here we see the buoy, the communication buoy on the surface, bottom left corner, in front of the Troll A platform during inspection we did there. Very nice picture. So with that, I'd like to round off by saying that we are ready to take on the challenge. And thank you very much, and stay safe and healthy out there.